Wednesday. Nicole Jones here. During my spiritual awakening, I have found that the first and foremost important thing is connecting to your higher self. So I just wanted to make a little video to tell you guys a little bit about who your higher selves are, how they directly impact your everyday life, and how to connect with them on a more fluid basis. So a little bit about myself. I am a wife, a mom of three. I have a dog, Sirius, who's right here, and a guinea pig named Wednesday. I have my degree in forensic science with a passion for art, which I have facilitated into a career as being a tattoo artist. I'm also a spiritual healer. I work with energy, and I also heal on a quantum level using hypnosis, connecting you to your higher self. So in my studies, I have found the importance of the higher self, and I've seen the amazing things that your higher self can do and help you with, healing sickness, healing the mind, but also helping in everyday decisions, with relationships, with careers, just everyday worries and fears, but also on a long-term basis, and helping you attain your long-term goals, whatever that may be, your higher self can help you with that, and it's super important to connect with them, because they know what's best for you, and they can see all the possibilities for the choices that you could take. The soul uses a variety of different ways to communicate with us. The most direct truth would be our intuition. That's the gut feeling. That's the feeling that you get when you know that things are going right. That deep down gut feeling. That's your intuition. The universe doesn't communicate in our language. Our language is very childlike. The universe communicates more through groups of knowledge, but also through emotions and feelings. So if you ignore your intuition, then you're going to develop anxiety and angst. And when you follow that intuition, it leads to self-development and self-growth. It develops you in your relationships, in your career, just an all-around person when you follow that inner intuition. That inner intuition is your higher self giving you clues and messages to get you on the right path. So to remain receptive to these clues and things is very important. They can come through in all sorts of ways. They can come through as dreams, which are super important. Dreams hold a lot of information. Messages can come through as texts that your friends will send, or a song that you can hear that you may hear on the radio. That could be super important. Just things that you see, little signs that you see. Let's say you're driving down the road and you see a billboard and it just registers weird with you, like, wow, is that a coincidence? But there's no such things as coincidences. They're all there for a reason. Every person that is in your life is there for a reason. Everything you see, everything is a different sign to get you on that right path. Your higher self is in communication with you, whether you're conscious of it or not. If you're a spiritually awakened person, or if you're asleep. It doesn't matter if you're spiritual or not. Your higher self is still there and is still guiding you. It's just if you become conscious of it, then you can read into those messages and understand what they're trying to say. Hi, bud. But you also have to use your discernment, because we have these things called egos. And your ego isn't a bad thing, that's the logical side of your brain. But your personal desires and your egos are different than your intuition. And you can tell if it's your ego or personal desire by the way you feel. If you feel right, if you feel happy, if you feel safe, content, those are all things that your higher self will make you feel. If you're feeling like, I don't know about this, I don't know if this is a good thing, then that would be your ego or your personal desire. And the importance of following your intuition is, even though your ego makes you feel happy in the moment, your higher self knows what's best for you over long term. And they'll see the probability of that choice and how it plays out over time, and they'll know which one's best for you in the long run, not just in the present moment. So who is your higher self? Well, some people think that we are human beings having a spiritual experience, but really we're multidimensional beings having a human experience. And when you grasp that concept, you can see reality in a little bit different way. You see the bigger picture of things. You understand that it's not just about this moment in time, because you exist beyond this. Your consciousness exists beyond this vessel. So we could explain it as, for example, let's say you are rowing down the river. You're rowing down the river of life. You're in a canoe. Let's say it's the Amazon. And you are just enjoying the jungle. You see birds. You see trees. You are just loving this experience. And you can see a little ways behind you, and you can see a little bit ahead, but not too far. You don't know what's beyond the bend. Well, your higher self would be like an eagle soaring above, a great eagle. And this eagle can see things far, far, farther than you can in the past and in the future. So that would be like your higher self. They can see time spherically. We see time in the third dimension as past, present, and future, but that's just a construct for the third dimension. So let's say you're rowing down the river and you listen to your higher self. You're listening to that great eagle above, and they say, you know what, I know you're having a good time, but you need to row over to the side of the river and pick your canoe up out of the river and get onto land. But you're thinking, you're like, man, I'm really enjoying this river. Why would I get out of the river? It's beautiful. But you're listening to your inner guidance, so you do it, you get out, and you're like, why? Why do I have to walk? I have to pick up this heavy canoe, and I'm going through hell trying to walk, and you're falling on rocks, and you're twisting your ankle. You're just like, oh, higher self, what are you putting me through? And you just keep walking, and you walk up this ridge, and you look down, and you see that right over that bend was a huge waterfall, and you would have plummeted to your death. And you're like, oh, I get it now. And you see your higher self, that great eagle, they told you to get out, and even though you didn't want to, you realized, okay, I'm going to listen to that intuition, and I'm going to follow that. But if you hadn't followed that, you would have died. And that's one way, that's one example that I can give of who your higher self is. They can see things that you can't. So even if you're living in the moment, they know what's best for the long run. How can you connect with your higher self? How do you make that connection to your higher self? You have to change your mindset. You have to change the way that you think. You have to live in the present moment, as in you appreciate the moment, is more so what I mean. And appreciate the beauty of what's in front of you. So let's say you're driving home from work and you're just in your head, you're like, I'm done. I'm going home. And you just end up at home. That happens all the time, right? You don't know how you got there, but you're just driving along. Well, if you're living in the present moment on your way from home from work, why don't you look outside and appreciate the sunset and all its beauty? Or look at the flowers along the road on the meadow on the way home. And just appreciate what's there in front of you. Live in that moment and love that moment. Another thing to change your way of thinking is to live life how you want to. To disregard the expectations of everybody else, because your life is just that. It's yours. You don't need to live life under the expectations of your friends or your parents or whatever anybody else thinks. Only you know what's good for yourself. You and your higher self. Together, they know. You know what's best for you. And that can be kind of hard because we all have influences. And friends, family, everybody has their opinion on how you should be living your life, how you should be parenting your kids, how you should be doing your job, or what job you should be doing. But if you live in that moment and you know what you should be doing, then live your life like that. Don't live under the expectations of anyone else. So once you're living in the moment and you know what you want, and you do it out of love and care, if you're living from your heart, and in every moment you're doing your actions from love, from care, from compassion, those are all things that are important. And those are all ways that you can connect to your higher self, because your higher self is always going to give you the truth and to give you the action of love. They are never, ever, ever going to tell you to do something hurtful or to be mean to somebody. So when you're aligning yourself with your heart space, when you're aligning yourself with love, you know that you're always aligning yourself with your higher self. So to get this more constant flow going, instead of it just being that gut feeling, that intuition, you can strengthen that connection once you're living and changing your mindset. You can have a constant flow, constant communication. So for example, me and my higher self, we're always in connection. I started out by, I meditate every day, but I started out small, and if it's hard, just start with 5 minutes a day. Just pick 5 minutes a day, whether it be the first 5 minutes, the last 5 minutes, your lunch break, any 5 minutes. Just go into a quiet spot, quiet place, sit there. Light a candle, focus on the flame. Just turn off your thoughts. Don't think about any worries, don't think about anything going on. Just focus on the flame and breathe. 5 minutes a day. Once you can get 5 minutes a day down, then you can start doing it longer for 10 minutes, 15 minutes, 30 minutes. That's all up to you and how you want to do it. So when you meditate daily, that grows your connection. Because when you turn off all the worries and all the thoughts, all the ego mind, then you'll start noticing that your higher self will start connecting to you through meditation. And when you're meditating, you'll start getting the thoughts and the answers to the questions that you were stressing about that day. The things that you were worrying about, those answers will start coming to you out of nowhere, just in meditation. And then later on, after you get that down, those answers will come to you in the moment. You won't even have to go into meditation to get an answer. You can just have that constant connection with your higher self, and they can tell you things as it's going on. As the occasion arises, then you can take it in, and your higher self will give you the answer that you need. The other important thing, other than meditation, would be to ground. You need to meditate and ground every day. And grounding, I mean, you don't need to go put your feet in the dirt every day, but that's very important. You should do that. But if you don't have that ability, if you can't get out in the dirt every day, if you're bedridden or life's super busy, you can also use the intent. So I do ground in the dirt every day. I'm a gardener, so I'm in my garden every day, grounding myself. But I also find time during meditation, I also ground by intent. So I set the intent and I imagine myself with nature, one with nature. So my favorite is to imagine myself on the beach with my feet in the sand, and I just feel the energy coming through my feet and pulsating into the sand. Just energy, like just going like roots, but just pulsating into the sand. And as I walk, I just imagine this, envision this. Intention is key. With intention, you can do anything. So set your intention to ground. Physically ground when possible. Meditate daily, and you'll see that your intuition will get stronger. That connection to your higher self, it will grow and grow, and you'll start reacting out of love just naturally. When a situation arises, let's say someone cuts you off and you're driving, and normally you'd be like, and get all mad, start cussing. Instead, you'll start reacting, and you'll be frustrated, but you won't have that same reaction. If someone cuts you off, you'll be like, they must be having a hard day, or they're trying to get somewhere quick. And instead of getting angry, you'll feel compassion for them. Doesn't mean you won't get frustrated, because they still cut you off, but it won't affect your vibration, it won't affect your feeling. You'll just kind of brush it off. You'll just let it go. So when you live from your heart, you'll start noticing that your just everyday things start changing. Things won't affect you as hard. Negative things. And the things that are positive, they will start affecting you more. You'll start feeling more love for people, you'll start enjoying the things that you have lost enjoyment and lost the joy of. You'll start noticing the beauty in the sunflower outside your window of work. And you'll start seeing the sunset every day and just appreciating those colors. Take 5 minutes a day, meditate, ground, align yourself with your higher self, and you'll notice that your everyday life will change, but also you'll be able to manifest things more easily. You'll be able to overcome relationship issues. You'll be able to deal with your career. Let's say you have financial issues. The answers that you're looking for will come more easily and in the moment. Thank you guys all for watching.